Hello there, I'm Aldra Hill, and welcome back to Victoria 2, playing as the French Empire. It's July 26th, 1853. We have dealt with the stuff in the Ottomans and the things. Now, we are sitting on 21 infamy, and we're finishing nationalism and imperialism. There are a number of events that we can do with the nationalism and imperialism. Most specifically, the really cool one, which is down here. We can do the plan of 1853, which allows us to declare war for free, it seems, on all these guys. But it looks like I'm going to need to put some troops over here. So before I do that, let's try and move some soldiers here. Where's my navy? Where are my transport fleets? Oh god, are they all in, over there? Oh yeah! I was waiting to declare war on America, wasn't I? Oh, Jesus. I forgot. We're about to lose, like... And this guy's about to freaking die because there's no naval base. No, there is! Why aren't you repairing? Why aren't you repairing? Oh, we're so poor. So first of all, I'm going to reduce my administration budget down to half. I don't know why I was paying so much money. And then we're going to sit quietly for a little bit. Because we can still declare war on the to Haiti. Soon-ish. But the CB does expire. It expires soon. Yes, it expires in 1856 in almost exactly 3 years. I also do have the ability to annex to claim Catalonia later, so I do want to do that, but I have to wait. I need to wait until I have some more cash. Whoa, what is that? I just lost like a bunch of money. Stop that. No. Venezuela defaults. They're fine. There we go. Thank you. Oh, great. Can I please repay my loans? Thank you. Just instantly repay them. Okay, so, we have a pile of cash, which is great. Pile of troops here, and I think what we need to do now is we do need to move our transport ships over. We are still building an absolute ton of frigates, that is probably why we're losing money. Yeah, I was trying to build a bunch of frigates, wasn't I? Oh man, can we just get some clearer transport? No, I don't want any clipper transports in Africa, stop that. I just want them in Europe. Sure. Because I have a feeling if I try to move these guys, they're all going to die. I really don't want them to die, but I really need them to get over here. Let's see what happens. So once nationalism and imperialism is done, besides the... Oh, also, I realized that this guy can now actually be made into a state if I had enough colonial power points. I do not, so I need to shift this guy off of Lower Canada. Remove the focus. Boom. Goodbye, focus. Now, we're going to take a look at the rest of my states. Is there anyone who does not have the correct education level? I am looking, and it looks like everybody has education. As far as I can tell. Yep, 30%, 50. Cool. So now we just need to consider what places need encouragement. So, Aquitaine's okay. Artois could use a little bit more. How are we doing for machine parts? Because we're making a lot of machine parts, I think. We make 11% of all machine parts. That is amazing. We need to promote that. Okay, so we need to encourage production of all machine parts. Thank you very much. We definitely need more clerks here. Which we are already encouraging, which is great. Avignon could probably get some. How many populations has Avignon got? Oh, wow. Like only 288. That's not great. That's okay. What else needs promotion? Ile-de-France. Ile-de-France needs more craftsmen. Yes, it does. Le Midi, possibly. Let's get Ile-de-France for craftsmen. Nice. And that leaves us with... Alright, National Imperialism is done. And that leaves us with all of that. Lovely. Clerks, craftsmen. Alright. Next up, we could get functionalism for better education efficiency, but I'm really not sure I need it. Everyone is already super educational. Like, we love education, guys. What I am concerned with is possibly continuing to get military tax. I'm very concerned about military tax. I'm worried that I am nowhere near ready. So one of the things I wanted to get is the breech-loaded rifles. Breech-loaded rifles are really good. I like that muzzle-loaded rifles... is separate from flintlock, and they come only now. Like, England started using them in 1800. England began the first rifle program, the experimental rifle brigade, in the year 1800. It became the 95th rifles that was part of shop, if you read the books. So we're going to get breech-loaded rifles, combat width, which is really valuable, and that infantry attack bonus is insane, and also colonial negotiations, which is amazing. Wow, if it's before... Look at that, 75%. What? So we can't even get that. Oh, okay, yeah. Wow, minus 75% for year before 1880. Machine guns, economic bonus, nimble logistics, and any great power... Okay, cool, so you can... You have to have all three... What? Oh, so this is different than the base game. In the base game, you just need to have one of these inventions to be able to forget colonial negotiations. So I can't get that either before 1880 or after 1880, or I have to have every one of those inventions. So the machine guns, and that obviously comes from machine guns. But then I also need economic responsibility and naval logistics. So I need to get down all the way to this tree as well. And economic responsibility. That's 1870 all the way there. Isn't that a lot of text? That's 1870? It is. Wow. That's harsh, man. That is harsh. All right, we'll start that because we're starting to prepare for our stuff. Cool. So now we have a couple of new decisions to make. The first one is we have the Plan of 1853, which gives us war on all those people, which we're going to do later on, because I can't really afford that just yet. We can annex New Caledonia. It'll give us 3 prestige, and get New Caledonia as a core, and prestige, and militants and non-colonial. So there's some interest in the French government of creating a penal colony, somewhere the enemies of the monarchy would be sent, allowing them to be far away from the continent where they can do no harm. Admiral Febvre de Ponte reports that the island of New Caledonia, off the coast of Australia, might do just the trick. Considering the British use the Australia for the same purpose, who would object to us doing similarly? Boom. That's good. So we get a free territory. And then we can also Valley of the Kings. Valley of the Kings, Egypt is potentially an endless source of our new archaeological discoveries. We petition the government for monopoly to carry out excavations in... Oh, no. In the Valley of the Kings, we can ensure these fantastic discoveries are rather than other great powers. So the problem is... To do this, I get excavation rights requested... And for 2 years, I get extra infamy. Or rather, I get a reduction of infamy reduction. Because I assume there's international pressures to say, bro, please stop doing that. Well, we're going to do it. So, boom. The permit, they grant it, has granted an exclusive right to excavate and investigate ancient ruins. So this is really good for getting prestige. And for a long time, you get permanent prestige every ticking. And you get flat prestige. And relation with Egypt. So this seems like a good time as any to try to... Oh no, the Dominions, we don't want to do that. We can't do plan yet until we're ready. And we are just not ready yet. I need 50,000 if I want to search for the Aegean civilization. So I can't do that. The Kutonu concession. In foreign language. I think it's a small fishing village on the coast between Lake Nuaku and the Aleutian Ocean. We should put pressure on Kingly of Dahomey to lease the village to French control. I have to have radar group doctrine and 45,000. I would gain a tiny bit of infamy, at least 45,000, but I would gain Kotonu from Dahomey. Okay. Libreville Protectorate. What the hell? What's going on? There's so many weird things. Okay. Any own province, the French Empire, and the continent of Southwest Africa. I have to have mission to civilize. And I gain Libreville from the French Empire. What? That's me. What? A protectorate in our town under the French flag. Okay, L-I-B-R-E. L-I-B-R-E. There. Oh, so I get a free colony. That's awesome. Oh, so I get a free colony there just by doing it. Why? The Brazilian slave ship carrying slaves in the Congo was captured in Luango. It's tasked with contributing to the British blockade of Africa. 52 of the free slaves were resettled in the site of Freetown. We seek to establish a protectorate at the town. Oh. So I have to have mission to civilize. Okay, and how do I get mission to civilize? That is, I want to say, here. It's there. And once again, if it's before 1860, I can't get it. Okay. God, there's so many complexities in this game. So in this mod even. So I have to have market regulations and naval statistics. So market regulations and naval statistics. Okay, don't have that. Don't have that. But I can get that eventually. Or if it's 1860, I can just grab it. The Kutanu. Okay, so where's Kutanu? K-U-T-N. K-U-T... Oh, no. Okay, it's obviously not called that. Oh, C-O-T-O. Okay. Oh, I gain this. Oh, so I just get a free state. That's wonderful. So better yet, not declare on them then. And if I do that, I gain a pile of cash. I just need to have 45,000 and have Raider Group Doctrine, which is there. So I was going to get that on 1853 anyway, so that's fine. What else can I unlock later? No, gain 5 life rank. That's really cool for later, but not now. Ooh, Archaeological Museum. If I have 15,000, I gain a bunch of prestige. Okay, cool. So we're going to move our ships over. We also do have more national focuses to do. So what could we do? I think maybe encouraging soldiers might not be terrible. Let's get Britain and get some soldiers. So did the fleet make it back? Let's find out. We're still making tons of frigates. And finally we're getting back our cash, which is wonderful. We're building a gigantic frigate fleet to try and contest people. Oh, now we can build the Archaeological Museum. Because of our cash. Now we have excavation, we should establish a museum in our capital, at least 15 grand. Done. Awesome. And as soon as those transport ships are here... Okay, we did lose 2. We lost 3. 4. We lost a few. Tensions dissipate. Yay. Alright, let's get a small force of troops. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice. And we will move you over here. Because we're going to be fighting Mobul. And then we'll just CB the crap out of them. I'm trying to build up a nice big bank of cash ready. Still building so many frigates. Oh my goodness. Look at the frigates we are building. I'm excited, guys. Whoa, look at that big old fleet. And there's Manifest Destiny because morale and war exhaustion. Thank you. And that's a call ally from the Ottoman Empire. Ooh. I don't want to do that. I really don't want to do that. I don't want to fight Russia. Do I want to fight Russia? Let's show the wars. Spain is against Morocco. Russia, it's the Crimean War. Isn't that a crisis? Oh God. Okay. Who's Russia allied with? A bunch of no names. Okay. Why do I want to protect the Ottomans? That's what I don't understand. I'm very scared. I don't want to be in this war. I don't want to be in this war. I am scared. We can remove nations from our sphere of influence. I'm gonna... Yeah, I'm just gonna remove that. There we go. Oh wait, no, the UK will join. Ah, oh, damn it. Whoops. Oh, I screwed that up. Okay, we're gonna resign that because the UK is gonna join, so we might as well. Let's all destroy Russia, man. Let's go. Let's go. I'm excited. I do apologize, by the way, if you can hear my fan. It's very warm in here. So I am wearing, I am having a fan to keep me alive. Oh, we are still very powerful. I like this. It's good, man. It's good. All right, our score is really good. The UK, US score is low, man. What is with their score? All right, so we will just buddy up with the Ottomans. Spill water down my face like an idiot. Okay. We will accept your call to arms, my friend. Ah, no. That means I can't do this war. Because I have to be at peace. Ah, no. Okay, then I will reload once again. Okay, hold on. And then we will declare war once again. My goodness, this game. God. Alright. It's just me. I have no problem reloading a bit when I make stupid mistakes like this. So first of all, we'll go to the plan of 1853. Born to lower middle class family in Lille, Louis Febvre is a subject of engineers of the colonies of Senegal. He plays a central role in the implementation of the plan of 1853, a series of ministerial orders given to Governor Proté of Senegal that originated petitions to the powerful Bordeaux-based Moron Plum, large shipping investment interest in St. Louis. The plan specified in detail the creation of forts along the Senegal River to end after control of the acacia gum trade from the interior. Oh, that's an interesting name. Gasificado the Wanderer. Thank you very much for the follow, buddy, and welcome to the stream. The plan specified... Fedbera's push to build fortifications further out comes to generate conflicts with Proté, and his protest to Paris over Proté's inaction quickly rewarded some sympathy in the government. If we were to appoint him to chef de battalion and then govern the colony, we could quickly put the plan in action and take control of the coastal world of kingdoms. Boom. So we are now at war. I love it. Didn't even get any infamy from that. And I would definitely call in against Russia as well. Let's go, boys. And the Ottomans have joined us as well. What? I didn't ask you guys. Oh, so we just gained it anyway. Oh, that's brilliant. So who am I at war with right now? I am against... Oh, it's Treza. They are actually against me. And add Treza to this. Oh, that's fantastic. You guys didn't even care. That's awesome. Okay, so it's just like a free conquest. It's a proposed peace's demand, and I would gain prestige. Okay. Could I add a war goal and just conquer them? Annex into this country. No, I would gain too much war score for that. That's fine. Oh, you know what? Maybe we should increase our budget. Boom. But there we go. Come on, ships, let's go. There we are. Oh, okay, this is actually super easy. That's fine. So now we're also fighting the Russians. Let's go to the diplo mode. They're also fighting the North German Federation. And me. And the UK. Oh, you are boned, my friend. You are very boned. Oh, Casey02, thank you for the follow, buddy. Welcome to the stream. Lovely to have you here, buddy. Yeah, I don't think I need many more troops than this. Alright, let's just wait for a little bit. This is semi-desert. All semi-desert, so no help whatsoever. We'll just stand here and wait for that to come back up. Nice. And then we're going to move our transport ships back over to the western part of France. Is this Les Miserables? No, but I'm going to make it Les Miserables, my friend. That's the plan. Ooh, Basque Nationalist. That's cool. Oh my god, look at all this stuff I'm building. And so Russia is now getting absolutely destroyed. Who is the leader of this war? Is it me? No. No, it's just the Ottomans. Okay, that's kind of weird that I'm not in charge of the war. That's kind of strange. Okay, because it's a status goal, war core. Okay, so I don't even need to really be involved in this war. It's fine. We are expanding a lot of things. Soldiers, craftsmen, clerks. Cool. Building some clipper transports. I think I definitely have some points to spare. I think I can probably try and encourage some investment elsewhere. Places. Maybe just try and grab some of these guys. Like, because there are resources here that we could take. Not really, though. Okay. Like, these guys. Man, why not? Let's get all the influence on these guys and just start spearing the crap out of them. No, but we could just declare war on them, and that'd be easier. Like, just nick them. Ooh, that would be nice. And my god, is Congo very heavily populated. Holy crap. That RGO must be completely full. Oh, wow. No, I don't really want to spear these guys, then. I'll sphere them if someone else starts spearing them. So I'll keep an eye on that. Anyone else I particularly want to sphere? Mexico is not an impossibility. Obviously America is. So let's try to do some investments on them, shall we? into Mexico. We'll chuck some money. Oh, will Mexico not allow investments? What? There we go. I'm just being an idiot. So UK has 10,000. So if we just drop a whole pile of stuff in there, let's pick some stuff that would help their factories out. Why not, right? Fruit. Okay, literally just fruit. However, they do have some dyes. That's cool. They have some interesting industries. That's pretty cool, man. You got some stuff. Let's find if there's anything useful. Like, do they have any iron? Or just anything even kind of slightly useful? Okay, they have a little bit of iron in the Durango state. Nice. So, and that's decently populated. So in Durango, I will build you, my friend. I will build you a steel mill. Yes, that is what I will do. And then you will be forced to buy stuff from me. I will also invest in their railway. There you go. I've invested in your railway, and now you must love me. Because now I am the investor. Oh, baby. Have I invested in all the railways that I can? Is there any more railways that I could be making in my own country? No, we're good. Awesome. All right, that's going to be this episode, guys. Do make sure you leave me a like and a comment on this video. Let me know what you think of the series so far. I was Aljunk, and team's been this Vin Victoria, too. See you next time. Bye-bye.